Come on, Paco. Let's get away from here.
And all in the name of our Lord.
Stop thinking about it. The Inquisition can read even your thoughts.
Get back.
Stand back.
Clear the way.
Stand back.
Make way. Make way.
Come on, clear the way.
Get back.
Has your highness seen enough, or will you stay for the burning?
I do not approve of making bonfires of human flesh. I've had enough, thank you.
It was your idea to go to the trial.
Occasionally, one must have a look at the world one lives in. But I will not give my support to this idiocy by watching a girl die.
They're taking the wrong woman to the stake. There's the witch. Believe me, Paco, she has the evil eye.
I wouldn't give the devil so much credit for beauty, Juanito.
Take care, Paco.
You really do deserve it.
Thank you.
Senores?
Your visit was
stand
a great
still, honor. Everyone.
Inspection.
Don't you know you should stand for an officer of the king? You!
Why are we standing here?
Who are you?
Her Highness, Doña Maria Teresa Cayetana, Marquesa de Villafranca, Duchess of Alba.
I'm sorry, Your Highness. I didn't know. My humble apologies. Men!
Tomorrow the whole court will know we were here.
Let them. It won't be the first time.
Thank you, Your Highness.
Your Highness.
Goodbye, Costillares. We'll see you at the corrida on Sunday.
Thank you, Your Highness.
I shall dedicate my bravest bull to you.
Thank you, Romero.
Greetings to the pride of Castile. I should like to ask you for this dance, Your Highness.
Go away. You're being a nuisance.
Mind your words, you bearded cockroach.
No, see here, you.
Jose! That's enough.
If he were a noble, I'd run 3 inches of steel through his ribs.
There's no need for that. Jose, go home and sleep. You're drunk.
Repeat that. Repeat that if you have the guts.
No, 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 Jose. Don't be childish. You go home and sleep. You're drunk.
Paco, let him be or you'll get yourself into trouble.
Repeat that.
Paco!
Why not go and let them brawl among themselves?
Go if you're afraid.
I'm speaking in your interest, Maria Cayetana.
The gun for his leg, Paco!
Paco!
Here we go.
Home, Jose. You've had enough.
Good, Paco. Good.
Señor.
Paco, you'll be all right. You'll be all right.
Leave me alone, Anita. Put me down.
Please. I'm going to get a doctor.
Will you
help
put me
somebody?
Down, Juanito? I'm not a dead bull.
This is no bull ring. You ruined me.
Can we go at last? It's been a long day. And we've sampled all the thrills.
Dr. Peral, I think your help will be needed.
Get some bandages, a tablecloth, anything, just so you hurry.
I bet one of Pepper's petticoats would make a good bandage.
One? I'm only wearing one.
5 doubloons, you're telling a lie.
Do you believe me now?
5 for the bet and 5 for the show.
Why, thank you, Paco.
May we be of some help? This is my physician, Dr. Peral.
My name is Francisco Goya, Your Highness.
Yes, I know. I do hope your wound is not serious.
No, no. It's really nothing.
You'll have to remove your coat. I'll try not to hurt you. You'd better sit down. Nothing serious, Your Highness. The cut is deep, but the tendons are untouched.
I can still kill a bull. In any event, a lamb.
It's more important that you can still hold a paintbrush.
Do you know my work, Your Highness?
Everyone knows your work, Señor Goya. You're the painter of the day. May I help?
Thank you.
But sometimes your paintings frighten me. It's as if I were looking at the truth too closely, too deeply. Can you explain that?
Sometimes the truth can be frightening. But it shouldn't be if we face it squarely. It's only when we avoid the truth that we become misled, confused.
There. And now, Señor Goya, you can go back to your painting.
I have a strange feeling, Your Highness, that I'm going to paint better than ever.
Not for a while, in any case. This wound must heal.
I'm giving a small concert at my home next Friday. If you find yourself bored with your idleness, I'd be very happy if you'd come.
I'd be honored.
Good night.
Good night.
An original Goya. Extremely valuable.
You have a great feeling for likenesses, Señor Goya.
I was just dreaming when I sketched it, Your Highness.
It was a strange dream. Perhaps I don't know myself too well. Would you like to do a portrait of me and help me find out? Or are you afraid of finding in me the truth that's so frightening?
No. Not at all, Your Highness. Certainly not.
Until Friday at 5, then.
Supposed to be.
I said, what am I supposed to be?
You are supposed to be a fancy old witch.
You are not going to see Alba.
Be quiet, Juanito.
I'm sorry, Paco. Get as mad as you like with me, but I can't let you go.
Stop babbling. Will you stop babbling?
Paco. The queen hates her. If you go, you'll never be court painter.
Maestro?
How is the work progressing?
As well as can be expected.
No original ideas, Francisco. I expect you to stick to the original design.
Oh, please don't worry yourself, Maestro. In due time, the cupola will be covered with false angels, false dukes, false courtesans. Everything is false when one stifles his own feelings.
Nonsense. Art means order, discipline, a sense of tradition. It wasn't by my feelings that I became president of the Academy, but because of a sense of duty. Art is as in life. We learn from those who went before.
Yes, yes, yes. I have learned from Velasquez and Rembrandt. The rest for me are dead. Now I learn from nature. If we artists can't show the world as it is, without camouflage, without adornment...
If you want to play the game, respect the rules. If you insist on being stubborn, I shall have no recourse but to excuse myself to the king in your name and ask him to turn over the frescoes to someone else. Is this your decision? Francisco!
Embrujado está mi corazón por la fuerza de esta gran pasión. No te abandono más, tu vida es para mí, porque tú eres mi verdad. Hechizado por tus ojos, sí, día y noche.
Who is the child? It's her daughter. Oh. No, her adopted daughter. The Duchess was lonely and wanted a child.
Porque yo estoy embrujado.
Senor Goya sent me.
He's not well.
Oh, yes, Your Highness. Very well. But he has so much work, day and night, painting for the king.
For the king?
Yes, for our glorious king, God save him.
Very well. You may tell Senor Goya he's excused.
Thank you.
Well, Monsieur Brignac, what do you think of our singer?
Wonderful, Your Highness. Congratulations. I would steal her from you if I still had my theater in Paris.
Oh, you will have it again. This Bonaparte can't last forever.
No, but he's very obstinate, almost as much as I.
My dear, we are all longing to see Maestro Goya.
Hasn't he arrived yet?
No, I'm sorry, he can't come. He sent his apologies.
Oh, that's too bad.
He's probably detained at a tavern, rescuing some lady from the clutches of a sot.
Your carriage is waiting, Enrique.
My carriage?
Shall we have some more music? Maria, come here. Would you sing us another song, Pilar?
Yes, Your Highness.
enough, enough, enough.
Take off those rags. Didn't you hear me?
Off.
Off.
Well, it's about time. You should have done it
sooner. I look so young. Let him see you as you really are, so that when he comes to pray here in this chapel, his people will always be in front of him. Always. Pedro, my easel. Juanito?
Here I am.
My paints, canvas.
God, God, please help me. Please help me, oh my God.
Now ask God to help us. Sing. Sing so he can hear us up there. Sing loudly.
Señor Jesús Cristo de la salud.
Did you hear that, Paco? The king!
Open up!
Long live the king whom God preserves.
Now and forever.
Their sovereign majesties are on the way here. Advance, guards! Man the door. Get those people out of here. Get them out. Clean up the place. Get those out, too. Quickly. Move quickly.
Let them be. They're my friends.
You keep your hands off.
Sorry, senor. Order. They'll have to wait outside with the crowd. Move the scaffolding. Clear the frescoes. Push the scaffolding into the corner.
With your Majesty's permission, I have the honor to present Don Francisco Goya, whose sketches your Majesty deigned to approve.
I should have known at once. All artists are the same. Paint all over them. Well then, my good man,
Majesty.
Señor Goya has been working day and night, Your Majesties, and he didn't expect to...
Yes, we were hunting with Manuel. Manuel?
Where is the Prime Minister? Señor Goya, Manuel. Our right arm. Did you know our Prime Minister is an excellent shot? Surprising in a man so taken up with affairs of state.
Your Majesty has no rival as a hunter.
Oh, well, yes. I suppose I'm not too bad.
Carlos,
yes?
Please, the paintings.
Oh, yes. Where are these frescoes?
In the dome, Your Majesty.
Oh, yes. Of course, of course. First of all, what is the subject? Well, gentlemen, we're waiting for your opinion. What about you, Navarre?
Your Majesty, I don't know much about painting.
You there, Bayeux. What do you think?
In my opinion, Your Majesty...
Why not ask our dear Maria Cayetana? Judging from her chronic smile, she finds all this very entertaining.
Yes, Your Majesty. I find Señor Goya's frescoes most amusing.
Amusing? You find a religious subject amusing?
No, not the subject. But the rather coarse way in which it has been expressed. I thought that perhaps here I'd find frescoes more worthy of your noble court. But instead, the artist has filled the church with the lowest people of Madrid. Beggars, loafers, ladies of the street, majas, majos, and even at the feet of the saint himself, he's put urchins climbing over the balustrade. Don't you find that amusing?
Your Majesty, I paint what I see and what I feel. People who revere you. I've tried to symbolically paint them so that they can be nearer to you.
Ah, oh, I see.
Yes. I've painted them looking down towards us. Not to show themselves off, but rather, Your Majesty, to look at you. To try and catch your eye, to try and speak to you. You who could help them, Your Majesty.
Excellently spoken, Señor Goya. A very good reply. We love our people. Would anyone deny it?
If Señor Goya paints only that which he sees, I'd like to ask where he saw the voluptuous angels that decorate the cupola.
Now, my dear Duchess, you are asking a little too much. After all, which of us has ever seen an angel?
These angels look as if he might have seen them at night, well covered with flesh and blood, like the majas of the street.
I find it hard to understand you, my dear. You persist in speaking of street women. Do they shock you, perhaps? If so, I am astonished, because I understood that beggars, tramps, and women of the street are your favorite companions.
If we're to judge people by the company they keep, I'm sure there are others in this noble assembly who are on more dangerous ground than I.
Well, an exchange of opinion is most interesting and not very frequent with us. Now, if we may proceed, what do you think, Bayer?
Your Majesty, Señor Goya has broken all the rules of painting. But I have never seen anything so powerful or startling in the history of art. They are well and bravely done.
I think that Señor Goya has earned the title of court painter. Don't you, Carlos?
Oh, yes, of course. Manuel, where is he?
Your Majesty.
Manuel, prepare everything for my signature, appointing Señor Goya court painter with all the rights and privileges of that office. Well, I think we've done enough for this morning. By heaven, late. No wonder the stomach calls. Do you like them? I have quite a collection. I'll show them to you. You're an artist. You'll appreciate them.
Congratulations, Señor. When we meet again, I hope to see you in an outfit worthy of the court painter.
Congratulations, Maestro.
May I express my deep thanks, Your Highness.
Excellency.
Amadeo Ramirez.
Come this way, please.
We'll follow him.
News, Manuel?
Nothing new, Your Majesty.
Ah, these French, never content with what they have done at home. It's a pity, Luisa, that you didn't hear the Perini Quartet written for me.
Have you spoken to Senor Goya about our portrait?
Oh, of course. Are we all here? Ah, here you are, Senor Goya. Almost the whole family. 3 generations. God be praised. Now, do you have any idea how we should regroup?
I think I have. Yes, Your Majesty, I think I have.
So long as we get it over with quickly. Long sittings are a bore.
That's my son.
Oh.
Your Highness. Your Highness, would you kindly stand in the position you were standing?
Haven't you finished yet?
Thank you.
Your Highness.
It's not easy to please everyone, is it, Don Francisco? His Highness the Prince here doesn't have a very lovable character, and not a bit diplomatic. He freely expresses unpleasant thoughts about everyone, doesn't he?
No.
You mean to say that he hasn't revealed himself about anyone to you?
Not at all, Your Excellency.
I can do a lot for you. His Majesty has great confidence in me.
Your Excellency, I'm only interested in my painting.
Yes, but there are...
Work.
Well, now, let's see. Well, of course, Your Highness. You see, it's broken.
Oh.
Now, don't worry about it. We'll fix it. Shall we go outside?
Huh? Thank you.
Good.
Yes.
Just a little bit. That's it. Just a little bit. Oh, no. Oh, wait a minute. We will get it higher.
There it is. Now, that's it. Now, come on, back up, fast. Fast. No, this way, dear. Fast. I must guess who it is.
Yes.
All right.
There was a time, Señor Goya, when you were too busy for anything but your court painting.
I beg your Highness's pardon.
I can tell by your elegant clothes. You've reached the goal of your ambition.
It may be. But I'm still the same.
It's your turn to be blindfolded, Your Highness.
Thank you, no. The game is over.
Don't go tonight. And in these clothes.
Ah, but it's a mode of the people, my dear Rhonda. It's a festival of the people, and I have promised to go.
Listen to an old friend of the family. Your father would never have approved of this.
But my father would approve. He'd find it highly amusing.
I must insist, Your Highness. There's trouble brewing tonight.
Her Majesty the Queen has warned you once before, Your Highness.
Exactly. And now you know why I'm going out tonight. Because the Queen has forbidden it.
Marie.
Oh, Santith, how nice to see you.
I'm glad I got here in time. There's something in the air I don't like. I've heard that people want to make the carnival an excuse for a demonstration against Godoy. Your presence would be misunderstood.
Let there be no misunderstanding.
Maria, please. Taking the horses.
Let them alone, Miguel. They're enjoying themselves. You can see to the horses later.
Your Majesty. May we look? Why, certainly.
This boy, he's a wonderful boy. He'll have to reign one day. A son is a great responsibility, Señor Goya. The doctors never managed to cure my sister of that mark. Malignant infection, they say. But perhaps it was for the best. At least she's never given me any trouble over men.
Your Majesty, His Excellency, the Minister of Justice.
Your Majesty.
Now what is it, Delgado?
Your Majesty, I beg your indulgence. I implore you, regarding this pardon for Montijo and his two brothers. I've been trying to speak to you about it for 3 days now.
For 3 days, you've been told to speak to Manuel Godoy.
But, sire, it's Godoy who wants the Montijo family out of the way. Tomorrow morning is the execution. I've examined all the proof, and we have none. We have no proof against these people, sire.
Please understand, Count Delgado. It is not my practice to interfere with the Prime Minister's policies and decisions. You disagree with Senor Godoy? Then you must talk to him about it.
Your Majesty, please.
Don't take it so much to heart. It's not the end of the world. Don't worry about it anymore. Here. Take it, Delgado. It's for you. A present from me. Isn't it beautiful?
Your Majesty, if I may be permitted. I'm only a painter, but I'm also one of your subjects. The people look up to you. They believe in you. If they can see their Majesty condemn the injustices practiced by the people around you, they will be encouraged to clear out of their minds all kinds of misery, fear, oppression. Your Majesty. Your Majesty, people's lives are involved.
I know. It's very sad. But what can I do? Manuel certainly has his reasons.
Your Majesty, there are people who use your name to justify the worst crimes. Here, in the palace, all around you. People who lie to you, deceive you, Your Majesty.
You have been listening to gossip. Let me make a suggestion, Senor Goya. You keep to your painting. You're a good painter. Leave the affairs of state to those who are competent. Keep to your painting.
What's happening, Manuel?
An uprising. They are burning my effigy. They call me a traitor because I came to terms with Napoleon. Well, I did it for them so that they wouldn't be overrun like the Italians, the Germans,
oh, stop it. Stop it, Manuel. You're losing your head. If you were as brave in politics as you are with women, the uprising could have been put down long ago. Why don't you call out the guards? Order them to charge and not to hold back.
I already gave that order. But there's a serious complication. The Alba is one of the crowd. It's she who put the match to the fire.
So that's how she obeys my orders. I will teach her who is Queen of Spain. I will teach her to try to overthrow the state. Thank you.
Come and join us, will you? Come, come on. Come
where's
on.
Juanito and the others?
They made effigies of Godoy, and they'll probably be burned.
Burn them.
Come on, you need a drink, Pablo.
No.
Well, what's wrong?
Your Highness. My name is Maria.
I see, I see. What a night of delusions. Everything's upside down tonight. Look at you. Look at the dress you're wearing. I know, you mix with the crowd. But beneath your dress is the fine lace and the silk with your pedigree on it. You see? You go out amongst ordinary people, but you don't like their blunt language. Well, I'm sorry, but I'm not a grandee.
I thought you were one of His Majesty's gentlemen, first painter to the court.
You decry my work. You're like the rest of them at the court. You even waste your time toying with one another to distract you from the emptiness beneath your feet. But I'm not going to be one of your toys. Do you hear me?
You're mad, Señor Goya. I pity you.
Good evening, Your Highness.
Good evening, Rojas.
What can I get for you?
Bring us a drink, Rojas, anything.
Well, Señor Goya, your idol has fallen. No, I'm not speaking of myself. I'm talking about your royal idols. I tried to warn you that day in the church. I wasn't laughing at you or your paintings. How could you think such a thing? They're beautiful. Much too beautiful for that nest of corruption in the court.
Maria.
Sanchez.
I've been looking for you everywhere. I was afraid something had happened to you.
Count Rodrigo Sanchez, Señor Goya. Please sit down.
Thank you.
Will you bring another glass, Rojas?
Yes, Your Highness.
Nasty business tonight. Worst outburst I've ever seen.
But don't you think a good storm clears the air? Clears up a lot of other things, too. I was just telling Señor Goya that idols have a way of falling in a storm. Even royal idols.
Please, Maria, as long as I wear this uniform, I must honor it.
I imagine it's beginning to feel a bit tight.
Aren't you also a functionary of His Majesty, Señor Goya?
I am an artist. I happen to be a free man, thank God.
If you're a free man, would you please dance with me? What does it matter?
Everything matters. Do you love him?
No.
But you have loved him. And he's not the only one. He still loves you.
Let's not talk about it now.
Through my resentment and suspicion. I've painted you 1,000 times, Maria.
And of all the portraits, which is the truest?
The one I'm going to paint tonight.
Tonight?
Now. Thank you. Maria, I love you. I love you.
Oh, no, no. No, please. You have to paint my portrait.
Come, sit down. You've had lovers. I know. I even know their names.
Not all of them, perhaps. And still, do you love me?
Maria, I don't want to know about your past. I don't want to hear about it.
Yes, I know. I know you haven't asked questions. No one ever asks questions. No one really wants to know why. I'm proud, Paco. I was born that way. I can't love you unless everything is clear. Please let me go.
Maria, have you ever been capable of loving anyone? Have you?
Perhaps I've never met anyone who was worthy of my constancy. Until I met you. I loved you. I never realized that feelings such as this could be mingled with bitterness. Let me go.
Maria, what's the matter with you? Look at me. Look at me. Don't you see what I am? I live, I breathe, I work. I love you, Maria. I need you. I need you. I need you. I need you.
My husband died leaving me alone without children. Quite alone among hostile people who judged and spied and gossiped. My only pleasure has been to scandalize those people, to scandalize the hypocrites.
You're not alone anymore. I play the same game scandalizing the hypocrites. We're both made of the same stuff, Maria. Both.
If I could only believe you really love me.
I do love you. I do. Like I love my work. My painting, my Maria, my painting.
I can't let our love become confused with the past. Let me go for a while. Let me think. I'll come back to you.
When? Tell me when.
Very soon. Very soon, I hope. But this time the waiting will be so wonderful, so new.
I'll wait for you always, Maria. I'll wait for you always. Maria.
Doing here?
Waiting for you, Your Highness.
I don't remember having invited you.
You seem to have forgotten the events of this evening. We are sometimes forced to forget etiquette. I want you to believe me, Your Highness, when I say that to help your situation, I placed my own in grave risk.
I'm not in the least interested. How dare you invade my privacy?
Wait for me outside. Do you realize, Your Highness, that among your papers, there is much that would interest the Inquisition? Voltaire, Rousseau, Montesquieu, all revolutionaries. As a faithful servant of His Majesty, I...
You dare speak of fidelity?
I'm entrusted with the security of the kingdom. Naturally, as a man, I understand you. Even admire you.
Spare yourself the trouble.
I spent an hour calming Her Majesty the Queen. There were definite orders. You disobeyed them. You mixed with enemies of the state, inciting them against me. Nevertheless, I managed to reduce your punishment to 1 year's exile. A mere formality. You'll retire voluntarily to your villa at Solinar.
And if I refuse?
You're inviting trouble. Not only for yourself, but for those dear to you.
I will let you know my decision.
Everything is decided. I will leave here only after you have left.
Tonight.
Immediately, Your Highness.
Any messages?
No, senor.
Now, Pedro, do you call this cleaning, huh? Come on, clean it. Clean it well. Well, what are those?
Why, flowers, Paco. These are all I could get.
Is that all? I said flowers. Great bunches of flowers. Now go. Take these to your latest lover and tell him to present them back to you with my compliments.
Oh, why, thank you.
And then get me some real flowers. Steal them if you have to. Try the gardens of the Royal Palace.
Right.
Go, Pepe, go. Did you take her the sketches? Did you see her?
Believe me, Paco, that woman is not for you.
How many times have I told you not to mix into my affairs, Juanita? She didn't accept them?
She's gone. After all, you knew, didn't you? She's made that way. Here today, there tomorrow. She's driven lots of men crazy. Now she's got it into her head to take a long vacation at her villa in Solinar. I tell you, Paco, it's better this way. Now you can get back to your work without...
Juanita, get my traveling bags ready.
No. Paco! Paco!
One must have passed through a similar misfortune to have an idea of the desperation that followed. The guards were so cruel as to forbid me to kiss Manon or to speak to her. And then I was unaware for a long time of what had become of her. Yes, go on.
Senor, well.
Maria. Where is she? Where is she?
I can't see you anymore.
Go away. Go away. Can't see me anymore. Go away. Go away!
Paco, I had to leave Madrid. I was exiled.
Exiled? Why, Maria? Why have you been exiled?
Please, please leave me.
Maria, tell me why you've been exiled.
I can't. I won't.
I won't let you become involved in all this.
You still don't know me, Maria. Tell me. Tell me why you've been exiled.
Oh, Paco, I love you. I love you.
Your casita? It's ready.
Let me see it. Oh, Anita, you may go. See if the child is still asleep. Paco. I thought it was supposed to be a secret.
I want to shout it to the whole world.
I love you.
Maneuvers. They're always on maneuvers. Your Highness.
Sanchez, what brings you here?
We're going to a post on the frontier, not far from here. I must ask your pardon for this invasion.
Oh, not at all. Is there anything I can do to help?
Thank you, Maria. Senor, if you need me for anything...
Thank you, Sanchez. I'm very happy.
Maria, Senor.
Good luck.
I wonder if they know what they're doing. I hope they all rot.
But it's war, Paco. You must understand.
Well, why did he have to come through here?
After all this time, you're still jealous.
Of everyone and everything. Even of your thoughts. I'd give anything to know your thoughts.
Is it so difficult? Aranda, has Señor Goya returned yet?
Not yet, Your Highness. Santa Cruz is a long way from here, and Don Francisco must have tried to avoid all the main roads, which are full of troops.
It's a dangerous trip. I shouldn't have... Oh.
But he knows the region better than anyone else. And he's adventurous.
Too much so.
You mustn't worry about him. He knows he has some dangerous papers on him. Your signature's on them. He won't risk them. You mustn't worry so much, Your Highness.
Thank you, Aranda. We mustn't worry so much.
Please, go on.
Consuela. Have you come to make sure I haven't run away?
Why should you? I happen to be around here on maneuvers. And camp life isn't very gay, you know. Nothing but men in the army.
Certainly not an ideal place for you, Don Manuel.
Very true, Your Highness. We are both prisoners. You in this lovely villa, I in my position. And sometimes prisoners understand each other. May I? Suppose it were within my power to send you back to Madrid. We all miss you there, you know. You're even more attractive than usual. Apparently, you thrive on country air.
And what would be the terms of this understanding?
Your Highness, we both know that Napoleon is knocking on the door of Spain. And you can help in this present delicate situation. The country's in danger.
And what do you propose?
That we unite our efforts for a common ideal.
Your ideal?
Our ideal, if you prefer. Napoleon would be infinitely grateful to anyone who helped him to come into Spain. Only temporarily, of course. Without sacrificing even one of his soldiers.
And you make this proposal to me? My answer is no. And if Napoleon tries to force the door, we resist. That's all I have to say.
But your people will be massacred. Don't forget, he's 1,000 times stronger than we are.
When the honor of my people is at stake, we don't count the number of the enemy.
When you get angry, you're very impressive. Very impressive. Really, you took me seriously, huh? A diplomat and politician must explore all possibilities. Is Senor Goya well? I have heard that he was ill at Zaragoza, rather a long way from here. I remind you, Your Highness, that you're an exile and not on a honeymoon with your lover. Senor Goya has 3 days to return to Madrid. We're tired of these troublemaking intellectuals who think that they can carry on as they please and at 50,000 reales a year.
I'll see that you're reimbursed.
That will not be necessary. He'll return at once to his work. What do you think we are? All blind fools? Enough evidence was found in his studio to hand him over to the Inquisition. And you know what that means? It means the end of a man, even if he comes out of it alive.
You really would do anything to achieve your aims, even if it means destroying a man.
Why don't you want to be my friend? Send that arrogant little painter back to his paint pots.
And if he returns to Madrid, do I have your word that nothing will happen to him?
Word of honor. 3 days. I'll come back to make sure. Maybe then you'll be less hostile.
No one has been here. Senor Goya must not know of this visit. Tell the others.
Adios, amigos.
Maria!
There you are. How's my little girl today? Huh? Did you have fun? Now let's do our little seesaw. Huh? Down you go. One. Woo! Two.
Ah, Senor Goya.
Hello, Anita. These aren't yours, are they? Anita, who was here?
I don't know. No one.
Now you go out and play, huh? You go out and play alone, and these are for you.
Now don't eat them all at one time. You'll get sick.
Thank you.
Paco, you're so late. Is everything all right?
Mm-hmm. Who's here today?
Why?
Why? These gloves were downstairs.
Oh, yes, these. A friend of ours. An officer who brought news from Madrid. He must have left them here. Paco, why are you always so suspicious?
I know. It's me. I guess I'll never change. Oh, they gave me this letter for you.
The situation's becoming more serious. Suppose they found you here with me, Paco. Then you'd have to go back to Madrid. They'd make you go back immediately.
Make me go back to Madrid? But who would dare take me away from you?
But you have to think of your work, Paco. You can't stay away from the court too long.
I don't care about the court. Maria,
Maria, darling, my life began with you. And I wanted to end with you.
I know, but... that's what you think now. But with all this worrying, I'll become old and ugly. And then you'll wish you had gone away.
Old and ugly? Maria, get those thoughts out of your head. Look. I'm going to make an original Goya out of you. You're going to be the most alive of all my portraits. We prepare the canvas this way. There we are. And now, we start with the lips. A little light brush here.
Paco, please be serious. You have to go to Madrid. You have to go back.
Maria, let's not discuss it any further. I'd only leave you if you stopped loving me and for no other reason.
My love. My love.
For no other reason, my darling.
Who took the letter to Sandra, Anita?
Miguel, Johannes.
And he said he'd come?
Before nightfall, Johannes.
Tomorrow's the last day. Goya is... he's a difficult person to be around for any length of time. As a matter of fact, it's becoming rather annoying. I hate these long, drawn-out goodbyes.
I know something about that.
Yes, Sanjeev. I can't be faithful to anyone for very long.
I hate to hear you talk like this. I'd rather you loved my worst enemy, anyone, as long as you really loved him. Why ruin your life like this?
You're not being very understanding.
So you want to use me so that you can get rid of him? Just as you did Enrique to get rid of me, and Goya to finish off Enrique, and all the others.
Sanjeev, how can you talk like this? You know that I felt differently about you.
Have you, Maria?
Oh, Paco, we have a visitor. But I forgot, you met before.
Senor Goya? Is this included in your maneuver, senor? I'm sorry, Maria. I must go.
But you've been here such a short time. Won't you stay for dinner? I'd like you to.
I wanted to pay my respects to you. That's all.
I was wrong, Sanjeev.
Senor Goya?
No. No, let me. Paco. Paco, it's over. It's all finished between us. You must leave. Please, please go back to Madrid. Paco.
Madrid?
Paco.
Oh, Paco. Paco, I love you. I love you. Go back to Hitler.
How I envy that man. How I envy that man.
What happened to you, Paco?
Paco?
Señor Goya. Señor Goya.
What's the matter?
Señor Goya. Send for Juanito. And for the doctor, too.
Yes, yes.
Fault. Fault. Everything is fault.
Please let me see him. Paco. Paco, I'm back. I've come back to Madrid. They told me you were ill. You must believe me. You must. There was never anything between Sanchez and me.
I don't want to hear that voice.
He was only trying to help us.
I don't want to hear that voice.
It's you I love, and only you.
That voice. I can't. No more. Please. No more. I can't. No more. Please. No more.
Paco, you mustn't excite yourself. I'm sorry, Your Highness.
Finish this.
I'd say from these, he's on his feet again, wouldn't you?
But some of his victims might never recover.
Do you recognize her?
At last, someone's put her in her place.
Had to happen sooner or later. Oh, look, two heads.
Your Highness, what an honor. I've put aside some recent foreign fiction for you. Very choice. Very, very choice. If you would be so good as to walk into my office, Your Highness, would you be so kind as to step into my office? These have just arrived. They are rare items. Rare items.
Who is the owner here?
I am.
Order of the Holy Inquisition. You are under arrest. Your shop will be closed.
But why?
For publicly displaying and selling under the title of Caprichos, drawings which have been judged offensive to morals and religion. The copies of the book will be confiscated.
But really, sir, the author of these drawings is Francisco Goya. Surely if the court painter himself has made
these drawings... Never mind. The Holy Office will take care of him, too.
What? Oh,
Stand back. Clear the way, clear the way. Open up here. Open up.
Back.
Clear the way.
Paco. Paco.
You.
Paco.
Get back there, you.
Come with me.
With all they have to do, can still find time to invent new dances.
Yes, Your
Majesty. Parfait. Seulement, si votre majesté voulait se daigner de suivre exactement le rythme. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3.
What a pleasant surprise, Maria Cayetana. We haven't seen you for quite a while. How long have you been back from Solinar?
That's right, my dear Maria. What's happening at Solinar? Must be beautiful down there.
Your Majesty, Don Francisco Goya is in grave danger. He's been arrested by the Inquisition.
What? But I know nothing about this. That dreadful Paco. What's he done now?
Since when have you been interested in Senor Goya?
He's the greatest painter in Spain.
I'm very sorry, my dear, but we can't disobey the law. The Inquisition is sovereign.
But your Majesty,
surely... Forgive us. We have some very urgent state affairs.
We'll see what we can do, Maria. We'll see.
Would you mind waiting for me in my office? I'll join you there. Colonel, escort her highness.
What was your purpose in drawing these caprichos?
To show the corruption of sin and folly.
Really? Now let us see just how you've done this. Here is one of your drawings. You call this one, What a Beak of Gold. In it, monks are admiring the words of a parrot preaching from a pulpit. Am I correct?
Yes.
Is that what you think priests do? Listen to each other speak like parrots?
In the Bible, it says
that... Do not quote the Bible to this tribunal. We know what the Bible says.
Under that drape, Senor Goya, is a painting by you that has been judged lewd, impure, and unholy. Offensive in the sight of God and man.
Do you admit that you painted a nude? Do you admit it or not?
Yes.
Don't you know that it is a mortal sin to paint a nude?
The beauty of woman is part of the beauty of creation. In any case, I did not paint it for yokels to gape at.
Here is the work that condemns him.
You have no right. You have no right to do this.
Can anyone believe that the sight of this body inspires only thoughts of beauty? It is an open invitation to carnal desire. to indulgence of the senses and to sin.
No, lust and evil are only in the eyes of the beholder.
Senor Goya.
The first nakedness of woman was the work of God, but the shame of her nakedness was the work of the serpent.
Is this a painting of a living person?
No! 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 I'm the only one who is responsible for this! I'm the only one!
Sit down, Senor Goya. You lie. Unless you are prepared to admit that you acted under the influence of the person who posed for you.
No one is responsible. No one posed for me. I alone am responsible. Do you hear me? I alone!
You have seen, my lords, how the devilish arrogance of this man clearly points to his guilt. There is no institution, no person, nothing that has not been an object of derision in this book. Now, I ask you that...
Senor Goya, the Holy Office has been petitioned by the Royal Palace to grant you clemency. We will grant the request. But let this experience serve as a warning to you. You have been blessed with great gifts. The Holy Office will watch how you use them in future. Francisco Goya, you may go.
Like that clock? A gift of His Majesty. Your painter is free. This is the sentence of the Inquisition. A simple admonition. Next to nothing. I took a look at the Capriccios. Very interesting.
Did His Majesty give the order for Goya's release?
Practically. Almost the same. But don't worry. I'll talk to His Majesty tomorrow. No question about it.
I've misjudged you, Don Manuel. I shall never forget this.
Are you in a hurry? It's been such a long time since we've talked. Sit down, please. Something to drink? I have some genuine French cognac.
Thank you, no. What is it you wish to tell me?
Why don't we try to close our account, Your Highness? Tonight you pleaded for Senor Goya. I arranged to free him so that again he'll be able to insult us all with his portraits.
And what can I do for you, Don Manuel?
Nothing, Your Highness. But if you love Spain, there are those whose full-time job it is to guide her destiny.
What do you mean?
Since this morning, an entire French army has been marching on Spanish soil.
Then we're at war.
No, we're at peace. The French come as friends.
And how much did your master pay you for this betrayal?
If you were a man, you wouldn't leave this palace alive. But it would be an enormous sin to deprive the world of your exciting beauty. Wait. Your Highness. What would your cooperation cost?
A sum you will never be able to pay.
Are you sure? Wouldn't a kingdom at my side be worth your while? After all, you're alone now.
You're quite wrong, Don Manuel. I've never had so many friends. And it's you who have multiplied them. Now I beg to be relieved of your company.
What price, Manuel? That's what I want to know. What price did that woman pay to make you give an order which I had already refused? I know you too well, Manuel. You don't do something for nothing. Watch yourself. I've made you, and I can break you.
Enter. Wish to see me, Your Excellency? Is our mutual friend still in the household of the Duchess of Alba?
Yes, Your Excellency.
Tell her it is time to act at once.
Very well, Your Excellency.
No scandal, though. A slow poison, like a long, incurable illness.
Yes, Your Excellency.
What's happened?
The royal family has left Madrid for France. One hears of the order of Napoleon. Godoy has finally repaid them for their trust.
But our friends, what about our friends?
Some were able to save themselves. Others have been arrested, surrounded in their homes.
Oh, I do hope they know I haven't deserted them.
The best proof is that guards surround you, too.
What are they afraid of? I'll run away?
Take your medicine, Your Highness.
Are there no messages, Anita? Has no one called?
No one, Your Highness.
No one.
Viva Josep Bonaparte, España!
Plaisir de vous voir.
Don't forget my offer.
Well, what is it? What's the matter?
So you've come to this, fawning on the French.
I'm a painter and I paint what I want. I don't have to answer to anyone.
In what world do you live? You really don't know what's going on? They're robbing us of everything, in exchange for which they give us a new king, Big Napoleon's little brother, so the fraud can be complete. And you're on their side. Oh, you'll get paid very well, Paco, with money stolen from our people.
Juanito.
It's all right, Paco. All right. I'm going away. You're a genius. Maybe that gives you the right to do what you want. And that is what I'm going to do, too.
Are you going to make war on the French army? All alone, Juanito?
I won't be alone.
Of course, of course. You can always find deluded people who are ready to die for something. Haven't you had enough of being deceived, betrayed, abandoned? Where is the king? He left. Where are the others? Where are the heroes of the drawing room, the champions of freedom? Where is General Alba, our dear Duchess?
Alba is ill, Paco, very ill. If she wasn't, she would be out there with us, resisting the French.
For these and other good and sufficient reasons, I, Maria del Pilar Teresa Cayetana, 13th Duchess of Alba, bequeath all my worldly goods and possessions to my loyal and beloved servants.
Power! 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 Power!
You've changed a great deal. She's not well. Not well at all. Go to her. Senor Goya, what happened that night at Solana she did to save you? There was no other way. Godoy threatened to destroy you unless you returned to Madrid. And she knew you wouldn't go, so she made you go. Believe me.
Your Highness, Senor Goya is here. Shall I admit him?
No, no, no. Ask him to wait. Help me, please. Would you come back later, please?
Night, Maria.
I didn't want you to see me like this. I wanted to be on my feet.
That's so easily done, darling. That's so easily done. Come. Come, let's try it. I'll help you, my darling. Let's try it. That's it. That's it. That's wonderful. That's fine. That's fine, Maria. Maria. Maria, I want you to get better soon.
Oh, it's easy now. It was a waiting. It's over.
No, 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 no. No, it was the wrong I did you. I was at fault. The moment I heard you were ill, I rushed right here. Everything else doesn't matter anymore, my darling.
Oh, how foolish of me not to have come ill sooner.
Duquesita, you will get better. You tell me if you were... If there were any real danger, you tell me.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes, in that case, I should have prepared a fine dying speech for you. I would have said, I leave to you the two things I love more than anything in the world. Yourself and Spain.
How beautiful you are. It's been so long since I looked into these eyes, my darling.
And I would have said, Paco, look for me in every Spanish face. And I would have said, live a long time and go on to paint even greater things. Paint Spain rising from this terrain. As it will.
Yes, my general, yes.
And I would have said, Spain lives through Goya.
Yes. Yes, and I would have said Goya lives through Alba.
Oh, Paco, I would have had such a fine dying speech. It would have almost been worth dying for.
No. Maria, have you always worn these?
There's one I'd like to give away. I'd like to give the Alba to you. The Goya you'll keep for me.
That morning at Salina, your portrait with these wings.
You haunt you sand in the harvest.
Never did I love you so completely. My soul was in that portrait. My life was empty when it was finished, my darling.
My life too.
Until today.
Until today. Oh, Paco. The portrait is so beautiful, and now I'm not.
Oh, Maria, that's not true. That's not true, my darling. You're even more beautiful than you were then. Only at that time, there was something in you I couldn't capture. Now I feel I can, Maria.
Paco.
Yes?
I would like to see the painting again. I want it near me. Please bring it to me.
My darling, I want to stay with you.
Please. Please, please bring me the painting.
Now?
Yes, now.
All right, my darling. Quickly. I'll bring it quickly. Wait. Wait for me.
Yes, I'll wait. I'll wait.